Strongyloidiasis stercoralis is a parasitic worm. It lives in the environment and then it can get into your gut via your bloodstream by getting in through your skin.
If your immune system gets compromised, the disease can go into more severe form. That's where the larva multiplies enormously and then it goes from the gut to other organs.
It goes into hyperinfection where you have huge numbers and then they can move out of the gut tissue and into other organs, and that's almost invariably fatal. We really need to get an understanding of how many people are currently infected, but we also currently don't understand where it's living in the environment, what environmental conditions give rise to its survival, so how it's actually passed from person to person.
At the moment, we're relying on one or two drugs, and unfortunately, we've seen a couple of studies that have shown resistance in animals, and it's possible that we could start seeing resistance to human Strongyloidiasis.
One of the challenges with Strongyloidiasis is that although it's readily treatable, we don't develop immunity. So potentially, you could be treated and then walk back out to the environment and become reinfected.
It tends to be associated with the more tropical regions, and it also tends to be associated with areas of disadvantage. And we think this is probably because places that don't have appropriate sewage disposal or rubbish disposal are more likely to have the worm.
We found that Strongyloidiasis is important to indigenous health, and we need to be trying to close this gap between indigenous and non-indigenous Australians.
There have been some individual community studies where they've done either screening for Strongyloidiasis followed by treating, or where they've just screened the entire community. And the estimates sort of range between about 20% through to about 80% infection rates. If we had a better understanding of the distribution, then the likelihood of increasing screen and treat programs is definitely there. Because I think one of the problems is that it's underestimated, so it's not seen as a disease of concern.